on this GitHub page here, in these repositories, there's LaTeX files. And we are going to grab those by clicking on this button to download these as a zip onto our local machine. And now we've got all these text files. And those are what we're going to put into Overleaf by starting a blank project there. So this is a, let's say, a year 12 maths test on all maths. Okay, so this is what we're starting with. This is the very, very bare bones blank file that they give to us. And we're going to click on this upload button and find those files that we just downloaded. And it doesn't matter if we overwrite because there's nothing really there to overwrite at the moment. Okay, click OK and we're good to go. So now we've got that code that was in that repository right here in Overleaf, where it's much more useful to us. I'm going to go into the PDF here, and I want to click on this recompile button. By the way, you probably are seeing the PDF right next to the code. If you want to just show one at a time, you can click on this split screen button. And now we have our maths test. So I'm going to teach you in this series of videos how you can start with this template and use it and just modify it, and you'll be 99% of the way there. You've just got to essentially write the questions, and I'll teach you what each of these files does and how you can use them and modify them, etc. One really, really useful thing is when we're working down here in main.tex, where we're spending most of our time, because this is the backbone of this particular exam. One really, really useful thing is to come up here and see the document class options that we are using. So we're in the exam document class, and we can actually toggle on and off code by commenting or uncommenting it. On a Mac, it's Command/, but if you're on a Windows machine, you want to check out these hotkeys here, and that will teach you how to do it. So now that we've got answers highlighted, when we compile this, this blank space is going to disappear and it's going to be replaced by the solutions to the problems in this exam. Really, really useful, obviously, to be able to do that for both yourself and for the student. So we're going to see how this is all done, and this will be our starting point. Just before we wrap things up, though, I do want to just mention very, very briefly what these files are all about. So the first one is the nuts and bolts code. This is the set of packages that we're using and the options that go along with those packages and any macros that we have found on the web or come up with ourselves. They all go in there. The layout, this is saying, how do we want our page? What sort of width do we want? What do we want in the header and footer? Where do we want our points to be added up? Do we want those in boxes when we print our solutions? How big do we want them to be? Cover letter, this is where you can put your test conditions for that particular test. In this case, because this is actually a practice test, I'm not even using that. You can see that I've uncommented that. Sorry, I've commented that, but if I did want to uncomment it, now when we compile the code, that test supervisor letter or whatever it is that needs to go on there, maybe it's instructions for the student, that will actually show up now, but not real useful when it's just a practice test. So I'm just commenting that by pressing Command/. So the nuts and bolts codes, we're saying, hey, put that in here. The layout of the thing, we're saying, put that in here. Here's where we're actually naming our test. So this isn't necessarily going to be for stage 2 specialist mathematics. Maybe this is year 12 mathematics. Okay, and you'll see where that's going to change when we actually compile the code. It's actually quite a good idea to compile on a regular basis, so that errors and things like that don't creep up on you. Where have I put that? Oh, that's over there on the left-hand side, isn't it? Yeah, year 12 mathematics right there. So that's where that change is ending up. Let's say that this is on learning Overleaf. Okay, so where's that one going to show up? Again, this is all just going up into the header and the footer, but in this case, the header. So SAT learning Overleaf. And then what I like to do is for later pages, I like to have a more condensed title up there. So maybe just learning Overleaf by itself. That's the short version of it. OAC, by the way, is the name of my school. So you could replace that if you wanted to do that. Now, I've got this for infinity minutes, which is a bit silly. Probably I want to do this as a 60-minute test, let's say. And let's say that I want notes and calculator allowed, or you might have a test where, you know, there's no calculator allowed. Again, this is just to briefly say what this part of the code is all about in that main.tex file. Okay, so it's starting to come together now. And then we actually get into the document proper. So everything before that was what we would call the preamble. And now we're actually getting into the nitty gritty. So we begin our questions. And when we're doing LaTeX, we always want to end things as well. So we're ending our questions here. Between those two delimiters, that's where we're going to put all of our questions. And that's this stuff that starts with a 5. So for instance, this particular question is a simple question for converting between radians and what have you. Okay, so we'll write a whole series of different questions. Every sort of question that I can think of that might be useful to people and ones that I actually use on a regular basis, I'll make a video explaining how I can do that. And that is what those are all about. So that will come later on. The grading table is where we're tallying up all our points. So because this particular paper here has lots and lots and lots of questions, just because it's revision for the students, I've got the grading table actually going vertical. It's up and down, as opposed to left and right. But if I did want to change that, I could just come and select that. I could comment that code there, and I could say, no, I would prefer to have a horizontal grading table. Now, I don't actually like to do that when I've got so many pages in my test, because then it kind of goes over the margins, which isn't great. Can you see that it's plopping over there a little bit? And so that's why I'm currently using this configuration as opposed to the other. And then finally, there's a formulae sheet. Now, this is the sort of thing that you often see in exams, a bunch of different formulae for the students so that they don't need to memorize everything. I've also put in a bit of extra space here for the students. All right, so that's that page. That's called the formulae sheet file. And we're putting that in right after the grading table. So first we're putting in the grading table, then we're putting in the formula sheet. And then once we're done with that, we actually end the whole document. Okay, so that's really nice. So I'll just quickly show you. So here's the extra space and the mathematical formulae. There's the extra space itself. Here are the formulae. Of course, you could go in and change those to whatever you want. And we'll do a video actually on how we could fix up that formula sheet and how that works. But that is basically the long and short of it. And I'm looking forward to hearing from anyone. If you've got any suggestions about things that you would like to see done, please drop them down into the comments and feel free to use any of those files that I've put up on the GitHub page.